Thanks, Steve, and sorry I didn't have any animal impressions. I guess it's a fish. I wouldn't, kind of make a movement. And I just want to say a special thanks also to Idaho Fishing Game and all the other partners that I work with. As Steve said, I've been here since December, and it's just been an absolute pleasure with all the partners that I work with. Just the collaborative efforts in East Idaho and through the state, in East Idaho for sure. So yes, thank you for the audience and the community for being here tonight for the third of our series, moving from fur to fins. So pleasure to be here. So just a little bit about what I do. And sometimes I'm still figuring that out. I've got a pretty unique role. I work focused on a lot of fisheries and wildlife restoration projects. I work with doing the land protection work, conservation easements in the greater Yellowstone ecosystem, focusing on Henry's Fork area, Island Park, and South Fork Snake, and throughout parts of East Idaho. So it's just been it's a really unique position. It's been really wonderful. So I'll be here for a long time. So I'm really enjoying the job. Let me move on through the slides here. So I was going to start out with a short 2-minute video of the Nature Conservancy and just kind of an overview of what we do out through the state of Idaho and the work that we're doing. So I'm going to, and then I'll go through a few slides of kind of the protection work that we've done, some of our ranches and property that we own throughout East Idaho. So bear with me while I try to get that. Let's see if I can get this started here. So we just recently celebrated our 50th anniversary in the Idaho chapter. So I think Tony Hardesty captured quite a few things in there as far as our partnership and collaboration. It is in our DNA as far as working with lots of partners. A lot of the work that we do couldn't be done with the support and partners throughout Idaho. So, so we also own a few different parcels in eastern Idaho. This is a property that we own over near Du Bois. It's roughly about 4,500 acres, and so we're working on a couple different projects there. So one thing I did want to capture with our Crooked Creek property is Crooked Creek and Myers Creek that's on the property, which actually has a pure genetic strain of Yellowstone cutthroat trout. So I wanted to kind of capture that tonight. And so some of the projects that Dan has worked on in the past, still currently working on, is eradication of brook trout that's been in Myers and Crooked Creek. And so they've been working, started I believe in 2009, to eradicate brook trout. And so here's just a photo of them with follow-up work doing electroshocking. So they're still monitoring Crooked Creek that runs through the on the property, through the TNC Preserve property. And so they're still looking at to see whether or not brook trout are still present within Crooked Creek and Myers Creek. And so they're using a couple of different techniques to follow up with the electrophishing and also with eDNA. And Dan will probably capture that a little bit better, much better than I will, so I'll let him cover that. So just a couple of pictures of Crooked Creek and Myers Creek on our Nature Conservancy property. And so on that property also, we're working on some sagegrass restoration projects, and so it's a property that we use. We actually lease out with a rancher, a local rancher in the area. So we actually do run cattle. We have 4,500 acres with 65,000 acres of base of allotments that we run through BLM and Forest Service ground. So we are working with different partners on improved grazing management plans and also in trying to improve some sagegrass restoration projects on the property also. So here's another project. The Nature Conservancy also owns another ranch up in Island Park, the Flat Ranch, and some of you may have been up there. And just one thing too is come up to our ranch and see us. You know, we've got a visitor center up there. We also do Matthew Ward is our Flat Ranch Preserve Manager up there, and he also does a speaker series throughout the summer months. It's open Memorial Weekend through Labor Day. It's open to for bird. It's a great birding area. Fishing also and hiking in the area. So this was a project that was started, I believe, in 2013, in the fall of 2013, reconnecting an old ditch line back to the historical channel. So this is the Upper Henry's outlet coming right out of the Upper Henry's Lake, where the Flat Ranch Preserve is. And so there was 1,000 feet of ditch line that was filled in, and a 1 mile of stream that was actually restored back into the historical channel. So these are just a couple of photos of showing the old ditch line right there through here, the straightened channel, and putting it back into the historical with all the different oxbows and reconnecting and just providing great fishing habitat. Just some aerial views of the Flat Ranch and the oxbows and the historical channel. So this is, I believe it's about 1,300 acres that we own on the Flat Ranch on Island Park. And also mentioned there was with the historical channel that was reconnected, it also improved 37 acres of wetland, restored wetlands in the area. And just finished up in 2015 with willow revegetation on the stream channel. So 37 acres of wetland, mile restored historical channel, and 1,000 feet old ditch line that was built in on that system. So definitely improved Yellowstone cutthroat trout fisheries habitat. So this is another project that we were a part of. This was actually provided. Damon Keene up in the Henry's Lake provided these photos with me. So. This was a project up on Targhee Creek on the Henry's tributary of the Henry's Lake, one of the four major tributaries for Yellowstone cutthroat trout. So this was definitely a fish passage barrier that the Henry's Lake Foundation and the Idaho Department of Transportation were big players in coming up with this project with all sorts of other partners, Idaho Fish and Game, U.S. Fish and Wildlife Partners Program, hate to leave anybody out, but those are definitely a lot of partners that came on board for this project. So this is just another photo after completion of pulling that old culvert out. There was, this provided access to about 5 miles of spawning habitat once that culvert was pulled out. This is on Targhee Creek. And then here's just the final, you can kind of make out, there's a nice big cutthroat trout hanging out there, spawning in Targhee Creek. So just a great project on tributary to the Henry's Lake for fish passage barrier. So that's about all I had with as far as the Nature Conservancy and some of the highlights that we've worked on and still currently working on. And so I think with that, I'd like to go ahead and just give a little bit of background information from Dan. Dan Guerin is a lifelong